also have live sessions on Instagram, Instagram Live?
Used to have live sessions on Instagram. Like we invite somebody from different countries. Like I had done my Instagram Live with Mary. She's from Nigeria. And we talked about how maths is used in fashion designing. Like she's a fashion designer, a maths teacher. So we talked about how maths is used in fashion designing. And we also used to do competitions on Insta Live where we put a question and the students have to answer those questions in the comment section.
Oh.
But that time we were free, right? But now we are all busy in our studies and college. So like we are not conducting Instagram lives and all for now. We are like creating posts for Instagram, but not lives, Instagram lives.
Okay. So, I mean, have you guys ever thought about making animation-based mathematics videos?
Yeah, I have thought about, but that takes a lot of time. And we searched for an animator, but we didn't find, because we are working free. We don't have that like amount to give somebody and they can work. Like a lot of students have the skills to do animation and all, but that needs money. And we are working for free. That's why maybe we will learn that skill and we will apply.
Yeah.
That can happen. We are not sure about, but I think that I have seen a vector space video on YouTube. I think that vector space is a topic which can be easily learned through animation.
Right.
A lot of students do coding and they make animated videos and post on YouTube. That is really nice. They can learn things and they can imagine those things. Vector space is the I think the particular topic that can be only easily taught through animation.
Subject in coordinate geometry, even let's say your circle or parabola, if taught through animation, it would become a lot easier.
Yes, yes. And the students start to imagine those diagrams in their brain. And that would be very helpful to understand a particular question which they have been asked in their exams or in their schools. So yeah, animation plays an important role, I think.
Yeah, and moreover, a good game to learn these visualization is Carrom. If you have ever played Carrom, I mean, everybody intuitively knows that where to strike that so that it will hit the board and have a rebound at certain angle, then go to that position. You don't have to teach that to anyone. They intuitively understand it. So I'll have to hit it at this angle. So that is a good way to learn about vectors in two-dimensional space, not in 3D space. Because in 3D space, I haven't come across any game which gives that visualization. But in 2D, definitely, Carrom would give you a good understanding of vectors.
Right.
You know what? When I learned Pythagoras' theorem in the beginning, within class 7 probably. So I had this kind of OCD kind of behavior that I always wanted to take the hypotenuse path. I wanted to avoid any path which had like first go right, then go 90 degree and then take another 90 degree. I used to say, why? I need to find the hypotenuse of this path.
There is some story related to Pythagoras. I will share that PDF with you. I haven't like read that PDF, but that is related to Pythagoras, where you will learn why they make that Pythagoras theorem and something like that. I haven't read, but yeah, that is related to Pythagoras, something really amazing story about Pythagoras. As we have came with mathematical space, we have also connected with a lot of students which are working in this field from 2 years, 3 years, and that is also a very really good feeling to connect with those people, and they have different perspective to see that maths. So yeah, that's really good that as a student we are connecting with different type of like educators which they are working in mathematics. Right. We really used to have like messages on LinkedIn where a lot of people connect with us, like we really liked your, we have account on LinkedIn also by the name Mathematical Space, and they seen that posts and videos, they really liked our content, they connect with us and they say that we are planning something, we will connect with you and we will work together on that particular project. We used to say, okay, good. It's a really good feeling to like connect with different people around the globe.